Najwa, and you're watching House of Color, and welcome to Marrakech.
Welcome to the Kingdom of Morocco. I want to take you guys on a little journey to North Africa, where I had the honor of spending a few precious days. We landed in Marrakech, and as soon as I stepped foot on soil, I could immediately feel the energy of this foreign land. The dust, the air, the busyness, it was all coming together like I imagined in my head. As we arrived that afternoon from a super long flight, we checked into the hotel, got our room, knocked out for a few hours to re-energize, and then decided it was time to explore. Luckily, the hotel was right in the Medina, which is where all the action takes place. We walked a few steps around the corner and found ourselves in the heart of it all.
We just got here and I think we're gonna look around and find something to eat. There's a lot of street vendors, so I'm pretty sure there's a lot of really good street food.
This is the main square, also known as Jemaa, and please excuse my Arabic in advance. Here you'll find tons of merchants, orange juice stalls, food stalls, snake charmers, magicians, donkeys, monkeys, storytellers, henna artists, pretty much anything. And as night falls, the square becomes more crowded and alive. I couldn't get too much footage of the action because people didn't like being filmed and photographed there, so I had to be very minimal with the camera. And also for safety measures, you always want to be alert of your surroundings and crowded spaces. After walking around the square, the sun started to set, and we found ourselves at this super cool, trendy Moroccan restaurant. It was a great welcoming meal with such tasty Moroccan dishes, the most spectacular view of the Medina, and the restaurant even had live entertainment to really give you the whole Marrakech experience. After dinner, we walked through the square and grabbed a glass of fresh squeezed orange juice. It was so sweet and delicious, you must try it if you ever come here. The next day was spent exploring the city, and the first stop was this gem of a hotel that is undeniably the essence of Marrakech.
Here at La Mamamue, I don't even know how to say it. Faked the funk and I told them we had a spa treatment so we can get inside, and we found a spot to take pictures, but it's locked, so no, we can't even go inside. But anyway, we gotta go before we get kicked out. In the
dark night, you're my stranger. We grabbed lunch at a local sidewalk spot which only served tagine, a traditional Moroccan dish kind of like an American stew.
There's chicken, olive, potatoes.
We made our way to the souk, which is a huge marketplace that sells everything. You can spend an entire day walking through it and probably never get to hit up every single merchant. And I mentioned before, people here aren't used to having cameras around, so shooting was kind of limited. Anyway, this guy brought us to a specialty shop that made pure argan oil and showed us the whole process of how it's made, which was super cool.
We're out at the souk right now, and it's just like a never-ending big flea market. As soon as we left our hotel, this guy came up to us and said, "Hey, aren't you staying at the hotel? I'm one of the cooks. I'm going to the souk. Do you want to come along?" And I was like, "Yeah, sure." So we ended up getting some argan oil. Hopefully we didn't get ripped off, because, you know, that's really a bad feeling. But I think I did okay. I got buy one, get one free.
If you guys like olives, this is the place to be. There were so many different types of olives, I wanted to try each and every single one of them.
So we just finished dinner and having mint tea, which is very, very popular here in Morocco. It smells so good. Try it.
The next morning started very early as we had a super long day ahead. We're going to Ait Ben Hattu, a very, very old and ancient city about 4 hours east of Marrakech. I didn't realize this, but the journey to get there was quite dangerous. We had to drive through the high Atlas mountains in a winding two-lane road, pretty much dangling off the side of the mountains for 4 hours in order to get to our destination. It was so scary, and I later found out that many tour groups get into horde accidents and die. Thankfully, we made it in one piece. But maybe I should chance it. Feel out of my ears. Teenager at the door. The sun is in my eyes. Will we still be dancing on shaky ground? So we're here at the palace. This is where a lot of films were made. It's pretty cool there.
Village, the 13th century, 15. Now we have 8 families, 40 people living inside.
8 families?
8. Wow. 40 people.
Hello from Morocco!
We lost our tour group. All right, we found them. We found the group. We actually followed the wrong tour guide all the way out to the exit. If you think this site looks familiar, you're not wrong. It's been the setting for a lot of movies, including The Mummy, Gladiator, Prince of Persia, and even Game of Thrones. It was a really cool feeling to be there and see this crazy structure with my own eyes. There are currently still 8 families that live here today, and I even got to meet a few of the villagers. So when we found our tour guide, he didn't really look happy to see us. He was like, Time! Oh, yeah, no, I was like, I was following the wrong guy! Sorry! He's not very nice. Hi guys, it's about 9 o'clock and we've made it home. It was 4 hours there and 4 hours back, but the ride is excruciating. Going there wasn't too horrible, but the return was actually really bad. I wanted to film some of it for you guys, but it was just too hard to look at. We just got back to the room and I slapped on my mud mask because it was like just building up with all the sand and all the dust that was flying through today to get all that dirt out. I gotta go because I feel like my mask is about to like harden up and I can't move and I can't laugh, you know? It's just like, don't make me laugh. Our last day was spent in relaxation at the hotel, which by the way was gorgeous. It was built in a traditional Moroccan ride style with a central courtyard garden and pool area. Every morning you can hear the birds sing and leaves dancing. It was an amazing way to start each day. We're here on our last day and we're having breakfast outside. I think we're gonna head over to the souk a little bit, hang out and find something to buy and bring home as souvenirs. And then we're gonna head out to Geneva and then go home. So that's it. I had my last cup of mint tea in Morocco that afternoon and used the downtime to catch up on some work and just take a moment to appreciate my journey in this beautiful kingdom the last couple days. I also got a chance to do something extra special on this trip. I got to meet one of my viewers. Hi guys. Say hi.
Hi.
She came all the way to have tea with me and I'm so excited to meet her. And she's telling me all about Marrakech. If I had one word to describe Marrakech, I'd say opulent. Everything from the decor to the food to the music, the city is an explosive burst of energy, life, and colors. I loved it so much and would definitely go back in a heartbeat. There's nothing more in life I treasure than the memories I make and the stories I get to tell from each place I travel to. I hope you guys enjoyed your journey with me through the beautiful Kingdom of Morocco. Be sure to subscribe to my channel for upcoming destinations and check out the last few places I visited. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time, and maybe in your own city. Bye!